Croeso! My name is Zoe Griffiths, I'm a mathematician, and I'm here to tell you about one of the interesting places GCSE Maths can take you. And we start with breaking news! Wales has more lottery millionaires per 100,000 of the population than any other region in the UK. And I found this out by looking on the National Lottery website, found some stats about numbers of millionaires in each region, and then found estimates for the populations in those regions. And yeah, you can see Wales at the top. About, on average, 10 out of every 100,000 people in Wales have been made millionaires by the National Lottery. And so I started thinking, well, what does this mean? Does it mean that the percentage, perhaps, of people in Wales who play the lottery is higher than in other regions? Perhaps that's the case. Or does it mean that there's some strategy that the players in Wales are using? What's that secret? And so this is Maths to Win the Lottery. Or maybe not. We're going to look at what maths has to say about if there is a strategy that we can use to help us make millions on the lottery. Because actually, we often see real newspaper articles suggesting that there is a strategy. So this one here is telling us that they have found the six numbers on the National Lottery that are more likely to come up than any other six numbers. And so let's look at how the lottery works. And so you've got 59 numbers to choose from, and you choose six of them, six different numbers. And if the six numbers that you choose are the same six numbers that come out of the lottery machine in any order, then you win, right? And you win a share of the jackpot. And on average, winners might get about £2 million. So lots of people want to win the lottery. I mean, I would like to win the lottery, which is why I got very excited when I read this article telling me how to do this, right? So this is how to win the lottery. And so we're going to use some maths to evaluate this. And to help us do that, we're going to first look at a much smaller lottery. So my micro lottery, where instead of having 59 numbers to choose from, you've got just 10 numbers to choose from. And instead of choosing six, you choose two of them. So you choose two of the 10 numbers in the lottery. And actually, I want you to do that because we are going to do a lottery draw at the end of the video and see if you win. But of course, you could whiz forward on the video and find out the winning numbers. So there is no prize. We are just playing for fun. So if you can write down your two numbers, you can pause the video and do that now. Okay, so we're going to do the lottery draw at the end of the video, find out what the winning numbers are. But before we do that, we are going to think about our chances of winning this micro lottery. And then we're going to use that to help us think about the real National Lottery. Now, one way for you to think about the chance of you winning this lottery is to consider how many different outcomes there are. So how many different pairs of numbers you could have chosen. So for example, you could choose 1 and 2, or you could choose 1 and 3, and so on, right? So how many different outcomes are there? But remember that you've got to choose two different numbers, and that the order those numbers come out of the machine doesn't matter. So have a think, stop the video now. Welcome back. Now, there are a few ways to think about this. You might have started by thinking about the number 10, right? Because there are 10 different ways of choosing that first number. And now often people say, okay, so I'm going to do 10 times 10 or 10 squared because there are 10 ways of choosing the second number. But actually what we've forgotten there is you had to choose two different numbers, and that once that first number comes out of the machine, it stays out, right? There's no replacement. And so then there are only 9 ways of choosing that second number. And so then we could do 10 times 9 to get 90 different options. And there's some good thinking there, but then that forgets that within that 90, we've actually got everything twice. Because we've got, for example, 1 and then 2, and 2 and then 1. But actually, they're the same thing. It doesn't matter what order the numbers come out of the machine. So we're going to take that 90 and divide it by 2, and that will leave us with 45. And that is the answer. So that is how many outcomes there are. But there are other ways of working this out. So you could have systematically listed those outcomes like you've practiced in class. There are a few ways of doing that. You might have drawn a sample space diagram. But actually, we've just discussed why 10 times 10 or 100 is not the right answer. So once you've drawn your sample space diagram, then you're going to go about removing the bits that we don't need. And we can't have the same number twice, so we're not going to want 1, 1 or 2, 2 or any of these red diagonal ones. But then, so that leaves, actually, you can notice then we're left with 10 rows of 9 in each. And so we can see where our 10 times 9 comes in. But actually, we've just discussed how that's not quite the answer. So there must be some more we need to remove. And you can see, I can see one here. So this one here is the same as this one here. So I'm going to remove one of those. I'll get rid of that one. And it happens again. So these two are the same. I'll get rid of that one. And actually, in the same way, I can remove all of the ones above that red diagonal line. And I'm left with 45 outcomes there in that green triangle. And that's the same triangle that you would get if you just wrote them out systematically by saying, I'm going to have one with two and one with three and one with four, all the way down to one with nine. That's that first column there. And then you go, okay, I'm going to have two with, oh, I can't have two with one. We've already done that. So then I'm going to go two with three and two with four, all the way to two with nine. That's that second column. And then you keep on going. You'll get that green triangle. And what's really nice is that we notice then that we can also get 45 by doing 9 plus 8, because we've got 9 outcomes in the first column, 8 outcomes in the second column, plus 7 outcomes in the third column, plus 6, all the way down to 1. And if you do that, you'll get a triangular number, of course, because we get triangular numbers by adding consecutive numbers. So 45 is triangular, and actually if you take any amount, choose 2. So if you have any size lottery where you're choosing 2 numbers, the number of outcomes will be a triangular number for the same reason, which I think is really pretty cool. But we get 45 outcomes, however you get there. And in this micro lottery, each of those outcomes is equally likely to come up. And so therefore your chance of winning the micro lottery today is 1 out of 45, which is a little bit more than 2%. Alternatively, we could find the chance by treating this as 2 separate events, where the first event is the first number coming out of the machine, and the second event is the second number coming out of the machine. And we're interested in whether or not those numbers match or don't match one of our 2 chosen numbers. And in order to win, in order to have a share of the jackpot, we need to have the first number matching and the second number matching our chosen numbers. So that's the route through the tree diagram that we're interested in finding the probability for. So if you want to try that now, you can stop the video and have a go. Okay, so you've chosen your 2 numbers, let's say 3 and 5, and we want to know the chance that the first number that comes out the machine matches one of those 2. Well, there are 10 different numbers that could come out the machine, so that's the denominator. But only 2 of them would match, so 2/10 goes here. And now we want to find the chance that the second number also matches. But this is, of course, given that the first one matches. So let's assume the first one matches 3. Well, then there are 9 numbers that could come out the machine where only 1 of them would match, and that is, of course, this one. So our 9th goes here. And now if we want to find the chance that both of these things happen, so the chance that the first number matches and that the second number matches, we want to multiply these probabilities, which is going to give us 2/90 or 1/45. So the same answer, different method. But whichever method you use, we are assuming that each outcome is equally likely to come up on this micro lottery, and that's true, and usually people are pretty happy with that. But if I start talking about bigger lotteries, we start adding numbers into our lottery and start saying the outcomes are all equally likely, people begin to question that, and they start saying things like, here is an example of 3 groups of numbers on the real national lottery, 3 outcomes. People start saying things like, surely group B is less likely to come up than group A or group C. They say things like, I've just never seen Group B come up on the National Lottery. And that's correct. Group B never come up on the National Lottery. But Group A and Group C also never come up. And it's just that Group B has got a pattern, so it's memorable, whereas Group A and Group C no pattern, which kind of makes them look a bit like lots of other groups of numbers. And that kind of tricks your brain into thinking that therefore Group A and Group C are more likely to come up and Group B is less likely to come up. But however counterintuitive it is, each group of numbers, each outcome on the National Lottery is equally likely to come up, works in exactly the same way as our micro lottery. And therefore, this article, just wrong. There is no group of six numbers that is any more likely to come up than any other group of six numbers. And what they've done is they've found the group of numbers that has come up most often in the past. And they said, so therefore, they're more likely to come up in the future. But each outcome or each lottery draw is independent of the next, right? So whatever happens on the lottery today is not going to affect the lottery draw in the future. And it also means no, there isn't a strategy that the players in Wales are using that means that the numbers they're choosing are more likely to come up. Each group of outcomes equally likely, or perhaps I should say equally unlikely. So how unlikely then is it for us to win the real national lottery? And we can work this out in the same way that we did with the micro lottery, right? So you could start by listing outcomes. Well, maybe not literally listing them all, might take quite a long time, but we could do a similar calculation. So you could think about how many different ways there are of choosing the first number, 59, how many different ways then of choosing the second number, and so on. But remember, you've also got to think about the repeats, which is a little bit more complicated this time. Or we could do multiplying probabilities. So we could say that each number coming out of the machine is a different event. So we've got six events, six probabilities to multiply. And it's your challenge from me to do this, to see if you can work out your chance of winning the real national lottery. And I am about to reveal the number answer to that question, spoiler, but I'm not going to do the full solution right now. So you can watch to the end and then have a go. That would be fine. So if you do that, and I hope you do, you will find that your chances of winning the national lottery, not one out of 45, but about one out of 45 million, right? So that means you are a million times less likely to win the real national lottery than you are to win my micro lottery today, which is just unbelievable. And therefore, these people who have won the lottery have done something really unlikely. And actually, to become a millionaire on the lottery, you need to not only have the winning numbers, but you also need to not have to share your jackpot with too many other people so that you end up with at least £1 million. And actually, there is a strategy in that. So if you choose numbers that other people don't like, then if you do, I mean, you probably won't, you won't win, but if you did win, then chances are you won't have to share your money with too many other people. Whereas if you choose something like, I don't know, multiples of seven, which are really, really popular, then you're probably going to have to share that money with lots and lots of people. So there's a strategy there, although today it doesn't matter how popular the numbers are that you chose. Isn't a prize to share. So let's find out then, what are the winning numbers on today's micro lottery? Are you ready? The winning numbers are 5 and 6. There we go. Well done if you won, you win pride. And we are going to finish with my favourite, or maybe my least favourite bit of this article, which is this bit here, which says, just by reading this article, right, the chances of you winning the lottery have just taken a huge leap. No, they haven't. It's still about 1 in 45 million. It's still really unlikely. So thank you very much for watching. This has been Maths to Win the Lottery. I've been Zoe Griffiths, and we've seen where GCSE maths can take you. Where can A-level maths take you? That's for you to find out. Hoyle!